हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ ट्विंकल पटेल फ्रॉम महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। दिस वीडियो लेक्चर इज अबाउट पाइथन लिस्ट। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल कवर पाइथन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस द कलेक्शंस डेटा टाइप अवेलेबल इन द पाइथन। आफ्टर दैट वी विल इंट्रोड्यूस लिस्ट, हाउ टू एक्सेस द आइटम इन अ लिस्ट एंड स्लाइसिंग द लिस्ट। आफ्टर दैट हाउ टू चेंज द आइटम वैल्यू इन अ लिस्ट, हाउ टू कंकेटिनेटिंग द लिस्ट। And after that, we will discuss the different type of methods available in the list, and then built-in function available for the list. So first of all, we will see different type of collection data type in Python. So there are four type of collection data type in the Python programming language, that are list, tuple, dictionary, and set. So we will briefly discuss here. First of all, list. List is a collection data type which is ordered and changeable. We can change the value in the we can change the element value in the list, and it also allow the duplicate members. After that, tuple. Tuple is a collection which is ordered and unchangeable. Tuple also allow duplicate values, but we cannot change the value in the tuple. Next is dictionary. Dictionary is a collection which is unordered, changeable, and indexed. No duplicate members is allowed in the dictionary. Next is set. Set is also unordered and unindexed, but here also the no duplicate members are not allowed. So these are the different type and main types of collection data type in the Python programming, which are very useful in Python. When choosing a collection data type, it is useful to understand the properties of that data type. So in this video lecture, we will discuss the list collection data type. In the further video lectures, we will discuss tuple, dictionary, and set. So, list is a collection which is ordered and changeable. In Python, lists are written in the square bracket and elements in the list are separated by the commas. So, elements can be any Python object, even another list, and list can also be empty. So, here, example, see here, we have a list named as this list. All the elements are separated with the comma and enclosed between the square bracket. So we have printed here our list. So here another list is printed, that is spring list, red, yellow, and green, and printed. A list can contain any Python object. So it may be numbers, strings, or combinations of strings and numbers. Here another example shows that list can contain even another list. So this list contains the 23 and 24 list. Next, list can be empty. So this is a example of empty list. Next, we will see how to access the item in the list. Just like the string, we can get any single element in the list using the index specified in the square bracket. We can access the list item by referring the index number. We can also write the negative index. Negative index means from the end. Minus 1 refers to the last element and minus 2 refers to the second last element. So here we have a list named fruits. Fruit contains mango, cherry, and banana. If we want to access the cherry, here mango has an index 0, cherry has a 1, and banana has a 2. So if we want to access the cherry, then we have to write in the square bracket 1. So print fruits of 1, then it will print the cherry. Now we will see how to use the negative index. So if we write print fruits minus 1, as we have stated that negative index refers to from the end. So minus 1 refers to banana. So fruits of minus 1 will print banana. Minus 3 refers to minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. So minus 3 refers to mango. So it will print the mango. Next, we will see slicing the list. Slicing means to specify a range of indexing. So when specifying the range, the return value will be a new list with the specified item. Just like the string, the second number is up to but not including. So here, see the example. Here we have a list named as a friends. So in the friend list, we want to slice it up from 1 to 4. So 4 is up to 4 but not including. So 1 to 3 elements are printed. So as a list are starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 is not including, and starting from 1. So Jia, Neil and Ria is printed here. Next we will see how to change the item value in a list. So lists are mutable. We can change the element of a list using an index operator. So it is very easy to change the item value in the list. So here consider the number list which will contain 10, 20, 30, 40, 60 and 80. If you want to change the fifth element in the list, that is 0, fifth element in the list is 60. So if we write numbers of 4 equal to 44, then it will change the fifth element in the list. So 60 is replaced with the 44. So it will change the fifth element in the list. Next is loop through a list. We can loop through the list item by using the for loop. So in the for loop, we can use the iterator variable. Using the iterator variable, we can easily print our list. So for I in list name or full list, we can specify it here. So for I in list, print I. So first I will get value 12, after that 15 and after that 8. And this value is printed here. So 12, 15, 18. That is all the element in the list is printed. And after that, end of the list is printed. Next, we will see is any element is in a list or not. For that, two operators are available in the Python, that is in and not in. So these two operators are logical operator which will return true or false. If element is available in a list, then it will return true. And if it is not in the list, then it will return false. So they do not modify the list, they only return true or false. So here we have a list of numbers 1, 34, 67, 890, 67, 786. So first of all, we will check if 67 in numbers or not. So 67 after that in operator and then list name, that is numbers. So 67 is there in the numbers. So this in operator will return true. Now next we will be checking if 76 is available in number list or not. So here we can see that 76 is not available in number. So this operator will return false. So in and not in operator is used to check is there something some element is available in list or not. Next is concatenating list using the plus operator. So we can create a new list by adding the two list using the concatenate operator. So see here we have two lists A and B. We want to concatenate two lists. For that a plus operator is used. So C equal to A plus B. So concatenate operator add the two list elements of the two list and return the new list. So here we have printed the C list which contain all the elements of A and after that all the elements of B. But it will not change the original list, that is A and B. Original list remains same and we have generated the new list using the concatenate. Next is list length. To finding the list length, length function is used. So here we have a list 1 to 9 numbers is available. So easily use the length function and pass the value of the list name. So length of A will return the 9. Next we will see the list methods. So there are different type of methods available in the list. To check how many methods and which methods are available in the list, we can use the dir command in the command prompt. So first of all, we have created one empty list, that is x, using x equal to list. After that, we have checked the type of x. So here type of x will return the list. And after that, to find out which methods are available in list, we are using the command dir of x. So it will return the different type of methods such as append, count, extend, index, insert, pop, remove, reverse, sort, etc. So we will see these methods now. So first of all, how to add item in a list? To add item at the end of the list, we will use the append method. But to add an item at the specified index, insert method is used. So adding the item, two methods is used, append and insert. So to add the item at the end of the list, append method is used. And to add an item as a specified index, insert method is used. We have a list named as fruits, which contain mango, apple and banana. Now, we want to add item as name as a cherry at the end of the list. For that, first of all, we have to write the list name dot append, and after that, in the double quotes, write the cherry. So, list name dot append cherry, which will append the cherry at the end of the list. So, mango, apple, banana and cherry is added at the end of the list. Now, to add an item at the specified index, insert method is used. Now, so if we want to add at the specified index, then insert method is used. For that, first of all, we have to write list name and that dot insert. After that, index value, and after that, the item name. So here, at the first position, we want to add orange. So that is 0, 1. So after mango, we want to add orange. So that write down the list name dot insert 1 comma orange. So here orange is added at the first position. So to add the item in the list, append and insert both methods are useful. Next we will see how to remove items from the list. For that, remove methods remove the specified item. So if you want to remove from the specified index, then pop method is used. And if we haven't specified the index in the pop method, then pop will remove the last element in the list. So see here example, we have a list numbers. So if we use numbers dot remove 78. So as we have mentioned, remove method removes the specified element. So 78 is removed from the number list. After that, a list is printed here. So 70 is removed here. After that, we are using the pop method, numbers.pop. Here we haven't specified any index. So pop method will remove the last element from the list. So 99 is removed. So 99 is removed, and here we have printed our list. So here our new list is ended with 88 instead of 99. Now we are going to specify the index for removing the element. So numbers.pop 1. So at one position, 22 is there. So 22 is removed or popped out from the list. So 22 is removed. So in this way, using the remove method, we can remove the specified item, and using the pop method, we can remove the specified index. Next method to remove the items from the list are clear method. Clear method empties the whole list, and another way we can remove the specified index, that is the del keyword. Del keyword is also used to remove the specified index. It can also delete the list completely. So see here example, see we have a list numbers which I have printed here. So del, it's a keyword, it's not a method but it's a keyword. Del, after that numbers 2, so 0, 1, 2. So 4 is removed from the deleted from the list. So 1, 2, 5 and printed. If we write del numbers, then it can delete the list completely. So del is also used to remove from the specified index. Next we will see the clear method. Clear method used to empty the whole list. So it's a method. Del is a keyword and clear is a method. So we will write down listing dot clear. So it will clear the whole list, and after that we have printed our list. So it will remove the all the elements from the list. Del delete the list completely, whereas the clear methods empty the list. Next we will see how to copy a list. For that, copy method is used, and another way to copy is to use the built-in method list. So here see the example, we have a list name HKMKSK. Now from the names, we are going to make a new copy of names, that is new names. New names will using the copy method. For that, we have to write down the list name dot copy, which will return the copy of the names. So new names contain the same element as the names. Next, using the list method, we will copy the elements of name. So using the list method, list and pass the name of the list. So it will return the new names 1, which have the same elements as the names. So using the copy and the list method, we can copy a list. Next is extend and sort method. So extend method is used to add the elements from one list to the another list. So see here, we have a two list, num1 and num2. Num1 contain 1, 2, 3. Num2 contain 4, 5, 6. So num1.extend num2, which will extend the num1. So now num1 contain a 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. As we have earlier discussed concatenate operator, that is plus. So using plus operator, we can also concatenate or add the two list, which will return the new list which contain the elements of the first list and the second list. But here extend method is used to add the elements from one list to another list. So one list is extended with the elements of the other list. Now we will see the sort method. Sort method is used to sort the list. So see here our example, we have a list name as friends. So list name dot sort. And after that we are printing the list. So our sorted list is printed here. Next, there are many built-in functions available for the calculation on a list. So which will take list as a parameter. So the calculation on the list will vary. We can do the calculation on a list very easily. So see here example, we have a list name numbers. So mean built-in function and then numbers, which will print the minimum of the list. Max built-in function will print the maximum of the list. Sum built-in function will print the sum of the all the elements in the list. After that, length function will print the length of the list, which we have earlier discussed. And after that, using the sum and length function, we can also find the average of the all the element on the list. Sum of numbers divided by length of numbers, which will give the average of the list. So using this built-in function, we can do the calculation very easily. So this is all about the Python list. Thank you.